EA Sports. It's in the game.
Tequio Spice, linebacker, Buffalo Bills. If it's in the game, it's in the game.
Madden NFL 2005.
Each of these teams looking to add a win to their record, and we're just about ready to get this one started as the Texans get set to take on the Titans. We're here for another great game. Welcome to the action. I'm Al Michaels, my partner John Madden.
These guys are lucky to have a quarterback like this to lead their team. He can make the best defenses look like some Pop Warner practice squad when he's at the top of his game. That secondary will have a hard time stopping him and his receiving crew at this one.
Derek Mason will be his go-to guy once again, and for obvious reasons. He's one of the better route runners and always seems to make the catch in traffic. Stopping this combo hasn't been easy for many defenses, so we'll have to see what type of coverages they go with to prevent these two from doing a lot of damage.
You can see these guys are fired up and ready to get this thing going.
They're lined up and ready for the kickoff, so let's go to the field for the start of the action. He got all of that one. No return on that kickoff, and they'll get ready to start the drive at the 20. Ball on their own 20. The quarterback gets set with only one back behind him. Gets the call. Sermon got very good penetration there. The defensive line wins that battle.
Yeah, and he was looking for a place to cut back, but the defenders had all their gaps, and there was no place to cut at all.
It's second down and a long way to go. Only one man back. Pressure coming, so they'll lose yardage on that tackle. The veteran slips in there and gets the sack.
Hey, you still got to give him a lot of respect. His moves haven't diminished that much, and he still makes impact plays.
John, this one will really challenge the offensive coordinators as they go up against two of the best defenses in the NFL.
Both of these teams have championship caliber defense. And I think if you talk to most coaches in the league today, building a Super Bowl team starts with great defense.
Swings it out to the fullback. Kalmus with the tackle at the 13-yard line. Jill, what's new?
I had a chance to talk to Coach Fisher just before the game. He told me that they need to step up their offensive production and jump out early here in the first half. If that happens, it'll force the other guys to play catch up, and that's exactly where he wants this game to go.
All right, Jill, thank you for the update. Here's the punt. And he signals for the fair catch. So the offense sets up for its first drive of the game. So they have first and 10 here. Throws it. Incomplete. He should have caught that one.
He did a nice job of getting off the line and getting into his pass pattern. But he had the ball bounce right off his fingertip.
The Texans come out in a nickel package. With the pass. Drop behind the line for a loss of a couple. He made a great play bringing in that touch pass.
The receiver never took his eyes off that one, looking it into his hands as he ran under it.
They have to get the ball inside the 34-yard line to convert for a first down. The Texans come out in a nickel package. Throws it. He hits his receiver. Coleman with the stop at the 38. Nedney comes out, hoping to put points on the scoreboard for the first time. And it's up. He missed that one. First and 10. Davis, the lone setback. Handed off to the back. No one is going to be able to catch him. Kalmus records the stop at the 45. And that gain will get them a fresh set of downs.
He just exploded towards the marker that time. That was a big time run.
So they have first and 10 here. Only one man back. Davis. Davis was dragged down before he could get to the line of scrimmage.
They have great size and quickness up front. That allows them to hold up against the run while also giving them the speed to rush the passer when they drop back the pass.
That first down marker just inside the 35. Carr scans the defense from the gun, dropping back with the throw. This one falls incomplete. No one near that time. Now it's third down after the incompletion. The Titans come out in a dime package. Surveying the field. Gets rid of it. The pass ball's incomplete. Two tipped passes in a row.
Yeah, and that's an adjustment the quarterback has to make.
Stanley will come in now to punt it away. Mason is the deep return man. Here's the kick. And he chooses not to return this one. First and 10. George, the lone setback. McNair with a man in motion. It off to the back. Big hit on the ball carry.
When you talk about getting unloaded on, that's what happened here. He just got unloaded on.
Couldn't find much of a hole, and he's brought down after a gain of what looks like a couple.
Yeah, you talk about push. This line got no push at all, and there was nowhere to go.
From the shadow of their own goalpost. Receives the handoff. He pulls him down at the 5. Olka couldn't get out of the backfield.
That was just a defensive line getting lower than the offensive line. When your defensive guys up front can control the line of scrimmage, it makes it very difficult to move the ball on offense.
Now it's 3rd and 6 coming up. He gets the count. Sharper records the stop at the 9-yard line. 5-yard gain. Right. So they'll line up to punt after going three and out. Here's the punt. From the 47-yard line. And he can't make anything happen on that one, John, as they tackle him immediately.
And that's because the guys on the outside were able to get downfield quickly.
Ball on the 46-yard line. Davis is the deep back. Going to the air on first down. Flings it to the outside. Bullock makes the play at the 44-yard line. Miller hits the reception, but it's only about a 2-yard pickup. Second and 8. Looking upfield. Long is the guy who's there to bring him down at the 34-yard line. A very well-drawn-up play.
And it was well executed. They hit their blocks, and the back found the right hole to get down the field and pick up a first down.
It's first and 10. The quarterback lines up with two backs behind him. Dropping back to pass on first down. Throwing. Off and running. Thrown behind, but caught. Jamar Gaffney is in there for the touchdown. Brown comes in to attempt the point after. The kick is up, and he tacks on the extra point. A good-looking drive, and they score the touchdown. And the offensive unit should be very pleased with their performance on that one.
Yeah, they were able to get some other players involved. Anytime you can accomplish that, you get your whole team excited.
The Texans are ready to kick this one off. Booming kick downfield. From the 3-yard line to the 20, the 30. Defense shut down the offense the last time they had the ball. First and 10. Calico, the motion man. He'll pass on first down. Under pressure, slings it to the outside. And he slips out of bounds at the 40-yard line. Holcomb gets the reception, but it's only about a 2-yard pickup. Nine yards to go. Collision up here.
He's feeling it right now. Either that or he's numb all over. And that's worse.
He might have gotten a yard or two.
That guy got knocked around by that defense. He needs a little protection from his linemen.
At the end of one, these teams are separated by just a touchdown. With the score, Houston 7, Tennessee 0. We're ready to start the second quarter. Now it's 3rd and 6 coming up. The Texans come out in a nickel package. Closing in, throws it. Incomplete. A jarring blow on that one.
Yeah, so good it knocked the ball right out of his hands.
very solid defensive effort to force the three and out. Here's the kick. From the 26. It's first and 10. They give it to the halfback. Big pop that time.
You want someone there to tell you to watch out because he just got decked.
Not much on that play.
Yeah, and that's what happens when you talk about a disciplined defense. They stay at home and wait for the runner to come to them.
Ball on their own 29. And brings him down. Davis did a nice job on that run.
If the defense keeps giving up runs like that for first downs, they'll have to make some adjustments to slow this guy down.
Ball on their own 39. The backs are lined up in an eye. Carr with a man in motion. Another run. Bullock created problems in the backfield on that play. About a one-yard loss. Second and long.
X right.
Pressure gets rid of it. Nearly intercepted. Sermon had his hands on it.
He's a pretty good cover linebacker. He can run with most guys, and he gets good position. Then he reads the pass and he makes his move. But he'll drop a few like that one.
And this is the fifth play of this drive. The Titans come out in a nickel package. With the throw, and he can't hang on. The third down pass is dropped.
The offense executed the play just the way it's drawn up. The receiver just couldn't get it under control.
Mason will go back to accept this punt. Here's the punt. From the 22-yard line. He had some room but couldn't get that one block to let him go the distance.
One or two more blocks would have sprung him.
Ball on their own 38. They'll go from the I formation. He hands it off. Payne brings him down at the 42. Good pickup on that play as they try to get the running game going. Establish something big.
I'd be running it with this guy, too. If he can keep getting runs and pick up 4 or 5 yards a pop, they should keep going to it. 4 or 5 yards per play is what they're going to need.
They need 6. It off to the back, fakes the handoff, and it's caught. Green makes the play at the 45-yard line. The defense blitzes the corner, but the quarterback got rid of it quickly for a completion and a first down.
That was a great play because he saw him coming, remained calm, and threw an accurate pass.
First and 10. The quarterback gets set with only one back behind him. With the pass, and he makes the grab. So they get 2 first downs on their last 2 plays.
They're getting it done by seeing the whole field and taking what the defense gives them.
There's 3 minutes left in the half. He can't wrap him up. Coleman makes the stop at the 20-yard line. Picked up 9 on the play. In my home, alone, if on the streets, I see beefs and water. 5th play of this drive, and they find themselves in scoring range. So they're inside the 20, need to get a touchdown. John, one of your favorite terms right here. I'm going to use it. Boom.
Yeah, but that's worse than a boom. That kind of hit could loosen your teeth.
Again with the run.
Foreman
brings him down at the 12. He was fortunate to get anything on that play.
And that's a tribute to their strength and conditioning coach. These guys spend almost as much time in the weight room as they do on the field. And you see it pay off when a guy can turn a play that looks like a sure loss into a play for a couple of yards.
The backs are lined up in an eye.
Pressure coming. Wrapped up and brought down. The always clever veteran gets to the quarterback.
And when he gets to the quarterback, he doesn't let him get away.
Ball on the 15-yard line. And this is the eighth play of this drive. 2 minutes left. McNair will work out of the shotgun. This pass is incomplete. Sharp was right there to break that play up.
He needs to do a better job putting the pass in a spot where only his guy can get it. Those tip passes can turn into interceptions pretty easily.
And they'll send the kicker out to try to pick up 3 points as the half is close to the end. Nedney comes in to attempt a field goal, which would give them their first score of the day. And it's up. The veteran kicks it through.
No problem for him. Whatever the situation, he'll approach it the same way. Cool and smooth.
The Titans have tightened it up. The Titans set to kick it deep. Not a bad kick. They'll set up for the return. From the 11. The defense will try to force them to punt again as they did the last time the offense had the ball. First and 10. Davis is the deep back. Dropping back to pass on first down. Under pressure, gets the pass off, and he dropped it. A little lob doesn't find its intended target.
The defense can't afford to take too many gambles by going for a pick when they should just try and knock it down. One mistake can lead to a big play for the offense.
Only one man in the backfield. Dropping back. Going long to the left. This one falls incomplete.
Watch this hit. He gets his helmet right under his chin, and wham, he takes him straight to the turf.
Third and long now. Let's see what kind of a pass play they go with to try to convert. Throws it, and this pass is completed. Echol pulls him down at the 47-yard line. They'd like to add a few more points to this lead, but we'll need to do a good job with clock management. Throwing on first down. Closing in. Throwing. The 40. Wolfo with the tackle at the 36-yard line. That'll move the chains, John.
Yeah, when you put together a great pass with a heck of a catch, that's exactly what you're going to get. They can run about anything here in the next couple of downs. I'm sure they'd like to get a touchdown out of it, and it'd be a real boost for them going into the half.
The quarterback gets set with only one back behind him. Kalmus is the guy who's there to bring him down at the 33-yard line. Pulled down after a minimal gain.
They just manhandled him at the line of scrimmage. I always say that if you win the battle in the trenches, it's going to go a long way towards your winning the game.
Let's go, Ball on the 33-yard line. And this is the sixth play of this drive. Just about a minute left. David. Solid hit. Just crunched it.
The thing is, when you get hit like that, it's like having a bumblebee in your helmet. You just can't get rid of it.
And this is the seventh play of this drive. They need five. The backs are lined up in an eye. Bruner, the motion man. Pressure, gets rid of it. He hits his receiver. He was really hit hard on that play.
Yeah, you talk about your decleaner. That's what happened there. He unloaded and he got a decleaner.
Pass play here on first down. Pressure coming. Throws it. And this pass is complete. How about that speed? Great individual effort.
He throws lasers all over the field. He can throw them short. He can throw them long. He can throw them medium. He can throw them anyway.
It's first and goal. The quarterback lines up with two backs behind him. Intercepted in the end zone. So the defense combines an excellent pass rush with good coverage, and it becomes a turnover.
And the key to the play was pressure. They force a quarterback to get rid of it before he's ready. And when he's rushing his throws out there, bad things are going to happen to this offense. One thing as a defender you want to avoid is trying to take a gamble for a turnover and then giving up a big play that lets them get points before the half.
Quarterback back in the shotgun. Passing on first down. Foreman makes the tackle at the 24. Picked up a few yards on the scramble, John.
He's one of those guys who's willing to run to make something happen. You have to be aware of that kind of thing on defense.
Second and six. So after the first two quarters of play, the score is 7-3.
Yo, let's do this.
Listen to this.
Come on.
As they line up to kick it off, we'll take a look at each team's stats through two quarters. And we're set for the second half. And he got all of that one, a great kick. We'll start the drive from 38-yard line.
This guy you can't touch. And if you're in the back, you need to step up front. And if you can't hear it, then tell him to turn it up. What the hell are you waiting for? Everybody in here.
It's first and 10. George, the lone back. Give it to the halfback. Robinson takes him down at the 40-yard line. John is still trying to move the ball on the ground.
This is a tough physical team that likes to run the ball in just about any situation. When you can run the ball consistently, it really wears down the interior line and helps to slow down those pass rushers.
The Texans come out in a nickel package. Dropping back, throwing. Behind him, but he has it. Good looking play there as they pick up the first down and keep the drive alive. Let's go to Jill Arrington.
Well, Al, the Texans coach was very pleased with how well his secondary defended the pass in the first half, and he stressed the fact that they can't afford any mental mistakes if they hope to maintain their lead. We'll have to see if they can do that,
Al. Thank you. That was Jill Arrington updating from the sideline. George. Foreman stops him at the 47-yard line. Short gain on that burst through the middle, maybe half a yard.
I don't think I'd call that run a burst. That was more of a limp up the middle.
They have to reach the 41 to convert. Gets rid of it, and he hits his target. Can't draw it up any better than that. Textbook first down. It's first and 10. McNair sends a man in motion. George. He records the tackle at the 36. They're trying to move the ball on the ground.
A running attack that is consistent and effective will help the offense dictate the pace of the game.
They have to reach the 30 to convert. The stop at the 29. The Titans are handling the defense right now. They haven't even had a third down in this drive. First and 10. Calico in motion. Hand it off. Sharper hauls him down behind the line, and he's brought down for a loss. Outstanding play by Sharper.
I'll tell you, that was a heck of an effort to get in there and make that play and force him into a big loss like that.
They'll get a first down if they can move the ball inside the 19-yard line. Dimebacks in for this play. He gets the carry. Play action. And he's brought down at the 31-yard line. He's flush in the pocket, isn't able to get anything close to what they needed.
That might be one of those times where you're better off just throwing it away.
They'll get a first down if they can move the ball inside the 19-yard line. Houston comes out with 7 in the secondary. Throwing, and the catch is made. McNair with a hot hand on this drive.
And what he's doing is sitting back there in the pocket, seeing everything, making great decisions, and getting the ball to the right guy. He's playing very well right now.
So they have first and 10 here. Only one man in the backfield. Slings it to the outside. Off target, but he goes down to make the catch. Caught the pass, but didn't go anywhere.
Yeah, the defense is real good at putting a quick end to completion.
A little over 4 to go. Drops back. Under pressure. Wrapped up and brought down. Smith drags him down behind the line. Great play from the defensive end.
He's such a disruptive force against the pass, whether he's coming after the quarterback or knocking the ball out of the air.
And they find themselves in scoring range. The Texans come out in a nickel package. Floats one into the end zone. And he had it and lost it. Incomplete.
This is just a beautiful play to force the incompletion. I mean, he gets up high, and he turns what could be a touchdown into a heck of a defensive play.
The kick is up. Plenty of distance on that one. Good kick. The Titans have cut into the margin.
The Titans
are lined up for the kickoff. Sends it sailing. From the 11. Houston is holding on by less than a field goal. So they have first and 10 here. Despite very little success running on first down, they still lead.
And running is important, but they've got other weapons that can get them in the end zone.
Bullock with the tackle at the 34-yard line. They went with the running play.
You never know when you're going to find some room and break loose into the secondary.
About four to go.
The quarterback lines up with two backs behind him. Off to the tailback. Davis didn't get any help from his offensive line.
It was just about impossible to run when you have guys in the backfield just as soon as you snap the ball.
Third and five.
Nickelback in this time. Carr sends a man in motion. And they go with the delay. Bullock makes the play at the 36-yard line.
They're going to keep testing this rushing defense.
The guy seems to get stronger every time he touches the ball.
Good defensive stand there. Now they'll punt it away after a three and out.
Here's the kick. From the 27.
It's first and 10.
George is the deep back. George. Robinson with the stop at the 31. That run didn't get them much.
Yeah, there was a defender in every gap ready to make the tackle on that play.
At the end of three, score is 7-6. The Titans begin this final quarter with possession of the ball, needing a field goal to move out in front.
Second and 10.
George lines up behind his fullback in the eye. Number 50 got very good penetration there. They lose a bunch on that tackle by number 50.
Yeah, he shot through the line almost untouched and made a great tackle on the back.
Third and long.
They come out of the nickel. Dropping back on the run. Misses the tackle. Drop behind the line for a loss of a couple. Brown gets stopped short of the sticks on that play.
Three plays, they lost yardage. Here comes the punter.
Here's the punt. From the 34-yard line.
First and 10.
They line up in the I formation. Hand it off to the back. Schulter makes the tackle at the 38-yard line.
That run won't move them far.
The lineman just failed to open up any holes to run through or give them room to work with.
Second and 8 coming up here.
Sermon holds him down behind the line. And that's now three tackles for him in this game. Lost some valuable yardage on that run through the middle.
He's got to look to make his move earlier. If he sees guys waiting there in the middle, he's got to look for the cutback lane or bounce it out, looking for a little more room to the outside.
The Titans come out in a dime package. Tucks it away. Eccles with the tackle at the 41-yard line. Well, that didn't cut it. Now they're looking at fourth down.
And they made the decision to just keep it on the ground. Take time off the clock, not force anything. This is a luxury of being ahead.
Nothing happening for the offense. They're forced into a three and out. Here's the kick. Fair catch called for. First and 10. Only one man back. Troop in motion. George. Big hit there. He was run over by a truck.
Yeah, two-ton truck pulling a trailer.
Good gain for the offense here in the second.
This is one of those guys who seems to play better as the game goes on. The more he gets the ball, the better he does. I'd expect to see him get quite a few touches here as the game winds down.
It's second down and seven to go. McNair with a man in motion. Hand it off. Fakes the handoff. Rosen. Green pulls him down at the 38. Kenny was there to make the catch for the first down.
He's glad he made that catch. I'm sure the quarterback will look his way again when he needs another first down.
First and 10. Give it to the halfback. Foreman with the stop at the 43-yard line. Gain of five on the play. They need five. Defense lines up in the nickel. Closing in, and he's tackled behind the line. Wright reached him and then brought him down.
He just ran out of time. He's got to do a better job of feeling the rush. You always want to keep your eyes downfield. But you have to know or feel when that rush is getting to you. You have to have a time clock in your head so you can get the pass off just a beat earlier.
Almost at the two-minute mark now.
I think this defense looks forward to these third down situations because they've been stopping them today.
Bennett couldn't find a way to get past the marker. Ball on their own 47. Sixth play of this drive. 2 minute warning coming up. Ball on their own 47. And this is the sixth play of this drive. And we've reached the two-minute mark. George. Play action. Gets the pass off. The 40. A solid tackle in the open field by Robinson. Pass play here on first down. He's looking. Drop in the backfield for a short loss. Changing the play now. Throws it. He hits his receiver. He did a nice job bringing that one in.
Yeah, either that or it just got thrown in there so hard it stuck.
Houston calls a timeout. They have two remaining. Third down here. They have to get it to the 22 for a first down. George, the deep man. Get the call. He picked up just enough. He finds his way just past the first down marker.
He knew how far he had to go for a first down, and pow, he just got it in there. The defense needs to be looking to force a turnover here, because if they don't, they might end up losing this thing in the final seconds.
They come out of the nickel. McNair with a man in motion. Holcomb
Sharper records the tackle at the 14.
The defense will be trying to strip the ball, so the running back has to protect it with both hands just before he gets tackled.
11th play of this drive.
So they need about three here.
Last time in the red zone, they picked up three. Now clearly looking for seven, but a field goal would give them the lead. George covered some good ground there.
Hey, nice job up front, holding their block and allowing him to get a good run for a first down.
Dropping back, guns into the end zone. Almost rocked in the end zone, so the offense still has possession.
And that's the last thing you want as a defender, to have the ball go right through your hands in the end zone.
Just over a minute still to go. Hand it off to the back. And they can't get any closer to the goal line after that play.
They had that one clogged before the offense even snapped the ball.
Pressure. Great play in the backfield by Sears. Sears went right after the quarterback from his defensive end spot.
And the sack really helps in the game of field position. It puts them in a long yardage situation, and that gives the advantage to the defense.
Ned will put them in the lead if he makes this. It's on its way. He made that one easily. Takes the lead for the first time today here in the fourth.
Yeah, they've been pressing all game, and they finally get it together to move ahead.
The Titans are ready to kick this one off. Going with the squib kick. From the 14. And it looks like there's a penalty on the play. So they have first and 10 here. Well, it's really not much of a decision here. They have to go for it. Gets rid of it. The pass is picked off. The pass rush had a lot to do with that interception.
That's exactly what happened out there. He felt the rush coming, and he was coming so fast that he threw it up for grabs, and he paid for it. I'm sure that he wished he had that one back as soon as he let it go.
With the defense not having all of its timeouts, they'll probably come out and take a knee here on first down. So they'll just wind the clock down and get out of here with a win. He'll take a knee. Second and long. No need for anything else but taking a knee here to finish this one out. And the clock runs out. The final score is Tennessee 9, Houston 7. Good job by both defensive units in this closely fought game.